Now let's create a new Android Studio project, selecting start a new project, empty activity, and I will name it as movie app. Okay. We have this summary for our request, our query request. So in order to access the movie, we get the ID of the movie. In order to search for a movie, we use the search path despite using the movie. And of course, we need to add the API key. And the query for details, we add the query details here, the API key and the movie ID. Accessing the page number using and page equal whatever you need, the page you want to access, and getting an image. This is the path that we are going to use in order to get the images. Okay, guys, for that, I will need to make a package name, a new here, a package called, this is utils. This is the utilities that we are going to use. And I will make a new class called, I will name it keys or credentials. This is credentials. This is class that we are going to use in order to get the keys and the string base URL. For that, I will create a public static final string called the base URL. This is the base URL that we are going to use in order to make the request for our IMDb, or sorry, the MovieDB org. I will copy this. I will copy this. Okay. Copy org. And I will paste it here. Now, let's create another constant called public static final string API key. So my key that we are going to use every time, I will make it as a constant. So this, I will copy this. Okay. And here we go. We have created a class, the credentials. These are the constants that we are going to use throughout the application. We are going to configure the retrofit into Android Studio. What is retrofit? Retrofit is a REST client for Java and Android. It makes it relatively easy to retrieve and upload JSON via a REST-based web service. In retrofit, you configure which converter is used for the data serialization. Typically, for JSON, you use JSON. JSON is a converter. So, but you can add custom converters to process XML or other protocols. Retrofit uses the OKHTTP library for HTTP requests. To work with the retrofit, you basically need the following three classes: a model class, which used in a JSON model as a JSON model, an interface that defines the possible HTTP operations, and a retrofit builder class instance, which uses the interface and the builder API to allow definition and defining the URL endpoint for the HTTP operations. Now, let's go and add the retrofit dependency. We go down to download here, and we get that this the implementation for copy, and we go to Android Studio. We select the Gradle and the API model, and here we put the retrofit, and we paste it. Now, we need to insert the latest version. Okay, we go latest G. You can download the latest jar in order to describe it into and import it into Java files and Java programs. And let's get the latest now, the latest version of retrofit. We click on this, the source code of retrofit and sample website available on GitHub. We go to this page in the GitHub and we scroll down. We see that they are updating them regularly. And we get here the 2.9.0. Okay, guys. So we go to Android Studio and we remove this and we paste 2.9.0. We click on sync now. Okay, and it's successful. I told you in that the retrofit need the converters. So in order to add the converters, we need to add the JSON converter for used for the retrofit configuration. Retrofit is a class through which your API interface are turned into callable objects. By default, retrofit will give you the same or give you same defaults for the your platform, but it allows for customization. By default, retrofit can only deserialize HTTP bodies into OKHTTP response bodies. These are the libraries, and it can only accept its request body type for annotation body. Converters can be added to support other types. Six siblings models adapt popular serialization library for your convenience, but till now we are going to use the JSON implementation. The JSON, we click on it and we scroll down and we get this implementation here, copy, and we are going to paste it into, sorry, I will get the converter, retrofit converter. Okay, the converter of the JSON, not the JSON, converter, here we go. Go to the, back to the retrofit documentations, and we copy this, and we go to Android Studio and add the dependencies here, implementation of conda squared converter JSON, and we put the retrofit version, which is 2.9.0. We click on sync now and we are ready to go after adding the dependencies and the retrofit and the JSON converter dependencies in our Android Studio.